Hey, math class. Okay, I wanted to talk to you about the videos that you've just watched from Khan Academy, and also to give you a tip. So in the videos, in actually both of them, he writes everything horizontally. So 3 15ths plus 7 15ths equals 10 15ths, he determines, right? And he decides that 5 is the greatest common factor, and uses that to simplify, to reduce down his answer. And, you know, this is fine. It's good to write them in this direction. But I find, and I want to recommend to you, to write your problems vertically instead of horizontally. And the reason for that is then if we encounter a problem where we have to do common denominator stuff, you've got lots of room over here to do that. Because, you know, in a problem like this, like, well, where do we rewrite the common denominator thing? I think it makes a lot more sense to do it this way. In fact, I think that so strongly that I will always write problems like this on the board. In this vertical way. They'll be like this on your handouts most of the time. So anyway, I feel quite strongly about it. Okay, so here I have this same problem. I can go ahead, oops, I knocked the stand, sorry about that wiggle there. And I see, 3 plus 7 is 10. Bottom number stays the same. Again, I'm dividing out the greatest common factor. And I end up with 2/3. And when you have written it vertically, like you just have all this room down here kind of underneath your problem. I recommend doing it this way. Let's look at another example. Because this one is going to need to have a common denominator, right? Let me raise this up just a little bit here. Ooh, because I feel like it's not all fitting on the screen. Maybe if I go this way. Technical difficulties. I have to tell you, this has been a huge day for technical difficulties. This is the third time I've made this video, so hopefully it will work. There we go. Okay, now we are all on this screen. Okay, 1/10 plus 3/15, and I need to find my common denominator, right? Because these two numbers here are not the same. 10 and 15, not the same. Okay, so I do that, right, by finding my multiples. Multiples of 10, multiples of 15. Tens are easy. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Dot, 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 right? On and on forever. 15s, though, they're a little worse. 15 times 1 is 15. 15 times 2 is 30. 15 times 3 is 45. Wait a minute, 30. That'll work, right? 30. 30. There we go. Common denominator. Okay, so 10 times what gave me 30? Well, it's times 3. 3 times 1 is 3. 15 times what gave me 30? 1, 2. So it was times 2. Got to multiply my top number by that as well. 3 times 2 is 6. Okay, 6. And so now I just add, right? 6 plus 3 is 9. My bottom number stays the same. And then once I have an answer, let me get these guys kind of out of the way here. Once I have an answer, I have to ask myself the two questions. So if you remember from the yellow sheet that I gave you, I tried to make it as bright a color as I could order it in, because it's just that important, those two questions. So the first question is it a proper fraction, right? And this one it is, because 9 is smaller than 30. So I have a proper fraction. The second question, though, is it as reduced down as far as it can go? And in this case, it's not, right? No, it's not. So I'm going to come over here. And remember, reducing has to do with the factors and finding the greatest common factor that can come out of both things. So it's different than the multiples. Don't you love how we're taking everything that we've worked on kind of in different days, and now we're smooshing it all into the same problem? This is good practice. You guys are going to be really good at all of this when we get done with this. Okay, so I'm going to write out the factors of 9. 9 times 1 is 9. 1 times 9 is 9. 3 times 3 is 9, right? Those are my only factors of 9. Factors of 30, though, oh boy, there's a lot more. There's 1 and 30. There's 2 and 15, like we just saw up here, right? 15 times 2 was 30. There's 3 and 10. There's 5 and 6. Oof, that's a lot, right? But which is the largest number on both of them? 3. So I'm going to come back over here. I'm going to divide out 3 and get my newly reduced fraction. Okay, so 9 divided by 3 is 3, and 30 divided by 3 is 10. I ask myself those two questions again, right? Is it a proper fraction? Yes. I have a smaller number on top than on the bottom. Is it, what's my second question? I just totally lost what was in my head. Oh, is it reduced down as far as it can go? And it is, right? How do I know that? Well, because this 3 is prime. See how everything fits together? The prime numbers only have factors that one in itself, right? So the only way I could reduce it down is if this 10 was evenly divisible by 3, which is not. So I know that this is my answer, 3/10. There we go. Let's look at just one more example just to make sure that we kind of have all of these steps down, okay? And this one is actually going to incorporate one other step. Hold on, I'm going to write this sideways and then maybe on the board. Ah, that shows up a lot better. Okay. I have 5/9 plus 7/12. So the first thing I notice right straight off the bat, no common denominator. So I got to find what my common denominator is going to be. And so I do that again by listing out my factors. So factors of 9 are 9, 18, 27, 36. 9 times 4 is 36. 9 times 5 is 45. 54, I'm going to stop because I'm at the end of my board. How about 12? 12 times 1 is 12. 12 times 2 is 24. 12 times 3 is 36. Oh, look at that, 36. Excellent. We can use 36. Okay. Right? 9 and 12, my common denominator is 36. So 9 times what got me to 36? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? 9 times 4, so I got to multiply the top number by 4, which 5 times 4 is 20. 12 times something gave me 36. 1, 2, 3, right? So 12 times 3 gives me 36. So now 7 times 3, that gives me 21. Okay, so now I'm done. Now I'm to the act. Now I can finally add. After all of those steps, I can finally add. 20 plus 21 is 41. Bottom number stays the same. So again, I got to ask myself the two questions. Is it a proper fraction? So that's my first question, right? And is it a proper fraction? No. No, 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 no. Sadly, it's not. That 41 is larger than the 36, right? So that makes it an improper fraction. So if that's the case, then I have to change it to an improper fraction. Oh my gosh, we did that on a separate day too. So you might have to refer back to some notes or some work we did in class. But basically what I'm going to do is divide my bottom number into my top number. Divide my bottom number into the top number. Now, 36 and 41, they're pretty close together, so I'm guessing that 36 only goes once into 41, but then I do have to subtract here, 3, once, 11 minus 6 is 5, 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay, so that means this right here is my whole number on top of the bracket, right? That number becomes my whole number, part of my mixed number. My remainder, usually I would bring it up here and write it as remainder 5, right? But now, I still want to bring it up. I'm just going to bring it up to make it the top number of my fraction. And my bottom number stays the same. Okay, so we answered question 1 over here. Now we have to answer question 2. Is it reduced down as far as it can go? And the answer is yes. Again, 5 is prime. Its only factors are 1 and 5. So the only way that it could be reduced down is if 36 was evenly divisible by 5, which it's not. Okay, we'll look at some more practice problems in the next video.